Hello guys, and welcome to a new episode of Storm the Castles number one. This episode we are trying to get the white world from this castle. So first thing we need to do for that is shoot this button. Fail. What a great start. Oh, come on. There we go. Oh, whoa. Jesus. Okay, that was great. Perfect. Let's get across. Kill Skelly. Fail. Kill another Skelly. Light up. Light everything up. Can't leave any dark spots. Oh my god, this is so fun running around spamming torches like a maniac. It takes so much time to farm all the coal for this. By the way, it's fun. That's all that counts. Yeah, let's light up this corner first. It goes really quick, you can light up ginormous areas. Really short time, if you have the right... if you have a proper amount of torches. Oh, and I'm out. That went quick. But I can make some more. So, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, kill the zombie. Next. Sticks, put the sticks, and bam! 3 more sticks, okay. Slide up more stuff, and then we have more coal. It's really awesome that we are getting more than enough coal, so I don't need to worry about farming charcoal. It's just so much simpler if you can just dig up the coal directly and you don't need to smelt it after you mine it. It's really convenient. Especially with a Fortune 3 Unbreaking 3 Stone Pickaxe, I can repair infinitely. Okay! There's a stack of torches used up, stacks of torches used up this video already, 3 stacks. If you check out my statistics at the end of this, see. What a crazy amount of torches I used in this let's play. I can imagine the number to be quite... Okay, that's going bad. Let's run. I mean, why can I not sprint? Okay, why should I be charging in a pit of monsters? Like this, that was completely stupid. I can just... I have an Unbreaking 3 Infinity 1 Power 1 bow. So I can just do this and be perfectly safe. Don't waste anything, and I can easily repair that bow. I have a spawner that spawns mobs that drop XP bottles. I kill the baby first. Okay, now I'm going to use the sword. Perfect! Let's kill this zombie. Spam my torches around. Woo! This one looks not naturally spawned. Get more torches on the bar. And we're almost at 5 stacks of torches used up in this video. Just to light up the front of the castle. Ouch. Oh, and I forgot to eat. Don't knock me in the lava, please. Okay, let's eat. Let's light this up properly. Okay, perfect. Let's make some more torches. Really going through the torches like crazy. This is insane. Oh, this guy is fire resistant. But he drops iron swords, which is really nice, so I can repair the smite 2 sword infinitely if that was indeed from the spawner. There's another one of those, so it's really likely. Not confirmed. No, didn't expect this guy to blow up. Okay, slide up this last corner of the room, and then we can travel talking. Okay, sure, go ahead, blow up. Woo-wee! Okay, that was a fail. Die, Creeper, and now let's finish the sword of zombies. Maybe I should save my sword for now. Or maybe I should just go and repair it now. Let's just go until it's broken. Someone breaking books would be nice by now, so I could put it on the sword, that would help a lot. Or someone breaking swords in a chest, whatever. Just need someone breaking. Okay. Let's run. Oh, dang it. Oh, spider got peaceful because of my torch. So good. The way to troll spiders. And I need to eat again. Using up so much food and so many torches on this map, it's crazy. Okay, this is lit up. Perfect. Think the Storm the Castle Let's Play mainly consists out of spamming down torches on the floor. Shouldn't call it Let's Play Storm the Castle, I should call it Spam Torches on the Floor. Let's Play Spam Torches on the Floor. Oh god. Which why, which no. Yeah, yeah, drink your speed potion, drink your health, drink your regen, and then I'm going to shoot you to death. That's how we do it. Okay, now I need to get some light in here. Those look like some spawners, so let's get them lit up. There aren't a lot of monsters in here, which is great. Okay, now I'm getting kinda cornered here. Wow, this one seemed to be spawning in the light. Is very scary to say the least. Combine those two sticks. Oh gosh dang it, Skellies, you and your aimbot. Hey, how did you survive that? At least this guy missed me. It's very nice. Okay, let's kill this creeper. Perfect. Oh yeah, I love this bow so much, I can spam it forever. Don't really have to worry about running it running out, cause then I can repair it easily. But it will last super long, cause bows with unbreaking spear are just insane. Okay, let's get out of those guys. Oh! I managed to successfully kill the torch. Such a hero. Okay, let's kill this zombie. And let's light up the rest of this. I don't know how far those spawners can spawn, but apparently very far. And there's still lots of monsters left. Get me a stack of torches on the hot bar. Okay, shoot all the monsters to death. Run out. Oh, what is the skeleton doing up there? Unacceptable. Skelly appears to be dead now. Okay, great. Yeah, zombie die. Using my bow for melee combat. Oh yeah, that's how we do it. Blow up, please. Ah, dang it. Okay, oh, a chest. Nice. Yeah, all the spamming torches has something good to it. We're finding a chest. Hey! Supposed to turn peaceful with all the torches. Gosh dang it, spider. What's in this chest? Strength 2 potion. Let's keep this in case we find the boss. Yeah, gimme. Or should I save it for when we find a hard boss from a hard area? Oh yeah. So we do it. How much health do those medium slimes have? 2 hearts? Yeah, it seems like it. Can take 4 fist punches. That's what 2 hearts are. So they're actually super weak. Weaker than chickens. No, exactly as weak as chickens. Okay! Let's light up the other side of this fortress, castle, or whatever. Woo-wee! There's a lot of mobs. Let's do it. Oh yeah. Oh god. Yeah, do some infighting, please. Infighting! Ah, of course they're not doing it. Stop spawning on top of there! Okay, let's kill all those skellies. Jeez! Oh no, I shouldn't back up so far, cause then the mobs can respawn. That was stupid of me. God dang it. Well, okay, not a lot of mobs that respawn, which is great. Okay, let's hurry up right here. Let's get this lit up. Die, creeper. Perfect. Two hits, that's how I like it. Is there another strength, two potions? I don't need to worry about saving mine. Would be very nice. Okay, bam, bam. Whoa, lots of torches this time. Ah, of course not. But some golden apples and some more building blocks. Oh, I actually forgot to grab building blocks. I meant to do that off camera. I think I went this dungeon with like 3 building blocks or 8 building blocks. Okay, and oops, let's go on the side towers first before we start to attempt the main tower. Ooh. Hello. That was lucky that only Enderman spawned there. Okay, where are we now? I got my feather falling 5 boots. Oh, I need to be careful where I jump here. Oh, okay, I see where we are. We were on top of the front wall of the castle. There's Skelly. Saving my sword too much here. Really should do more sword combat. Oh. I was like, where are those zombies? Oh yeah. Oh, that was too. Perfect! Now everything in this castle and of course it's silverfish, what else would it be? Oh, and of course two are spawning because we are still in 1.7. Yeah, those are the iron armor zombies. That's exactly what I thought. Let's run up here. Am I in hard mode? Yeah, okay. Well, I'm in the easy area, so the skeleton fall. No, that's not the boss. Punch two skeletons up here, are you freaking kidding me? Oh yeah, right. That's where they are. It's really mean. Still don't have an iron pickaxe, that's unacceptable. Should have farmed one. Get away. Too much trash. Gosh, dang it. What did give me a sword? Repairing a sword is enough to get the sword achievement. So awesome to know. I'm getting all the achievements. Yay, I'm so happy. There's a dual spawner of. Oh god. I didn't see that spawner and that spawner. I need to. Oh, there's some loot up there. How did I miss that? Okay, let's wipe out this one. Because there's a double spawner of those at the bottom. So if I'm going to make a farm, I won't make it up here. Okay, I need to remember those loots. Let's run up further. Right here. And lots of darkness. White fleecy boss. Say goodbye. Say goodbye. Whoa! Woo! Okay, two hits of those zombies and I'm basically dead. Keep that in mind. Wow, I almost wrecked my sword there. Let's get the white wool. Yeah, yeah, I got iron. Okay, awesome. That's a funny 5. Interesting. Stick of arrows. Okay, this is where the boss is spawning. Obviously cannot break the spawner. So, is there anything else? The white wool boss was super easy to kill. As expected, nothing else up here. Okay, let's run. Now that it's set to that it can spawn without light, that would be really trolly. Let's throw the sword down there so I can pick up this. Okay, great! Making fantastic progress once again. Well, those guys coming back. Now I have the stupid sword. Okay, lots of dark space up here. I'm so glad I got those feather falling fight boots. Whoa! This dodge is on that butt. Quick. Haha! Eat that, Skelly. Get blocked and knocked down. Okay, now we can investigate this right there. Shed and I put to get down easily. And I want to pick all of this stuff up right here. Is there a chest anywhere? Right, wasn't there a chest like down here? Wow, how did you spawn right there? Is that really dark enough? Oh, that was stupid. Yep. Oh, if they do a call to help, they only get one free. That's good to know. And I won't need this one as well. I need a box really quickly. Wow! Those guys all fell down apparently. Oh, they can spawn without light. Okay, and that's not lit up right there. What is that even? I don't know. Where was the closest box? We need to get up those towers again, cause I completely missed the chest there. Yeah, we can probably store some stuff there once we destroy the... There is no staircase up there. How am I supposed to get there then? Guess I need to forge my own path. Let's do that real quick. Cause why not? And I hear the punch skelly spawning already. Can I dig? No, I can't dig. It's a clear nope. Let's just place blocks, but then we can combine this. Which will save space. Okay, come whoa. Whoa! This knockback is so stupid. Oh, I have a feeling the spawner is set to spawn super quickly. Ah, they're knocking each other off. Is it only me or is punch on the bow like giving upwards velocity? Okay, great. Woo! Sun 3, Feather Falling 4, Iron Boots, great! Okay, so we don't have to worry about those boots running out, and now let's store some stuff that I will get off camera. I won't need this currently. Okay, looking great, looking great. And I keep the wool on me to make stuff more interesting, I guess. And how should I get over there? I don't think I need to light up every single bit of this area. I mean, I could run across there and light that up, but I don't think that's really worth it. Look at that, how cool that looks, so lit up. Entire floor is glowing. Okay, I need to go there now. Let's not get too distracted. Now we have a kinda empty inventory again, which is nice, don't fall off, please. Suck, even though I have feather falling, it would still hurt. Okay, I can't take a shortcut, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, we are completely down anyway now. So, let's move over there. And once we are done with this, I'm going to head back to base. And then we can look what we are doing from there. We still have time left, or if we call it, let's see. Okay, anyway, let's dig up. Light this room up, nothing spawned luckily. Then we can take on. After that, we are already going for the orange wool. So, second objective, and we are in episode 3, which isn't bad at all. Oh, okay, this guy will cause trouble. Wait, we can let him taste his own medicine, knockback. Oh, yeah. Great! Okay, what's up here? Pants, knockback 2, flame 1, regen. Cool! Cool stuff, I will... Well, I can take that now. nothing. And a back flame. Okay, I'm not gonna use the flame properly. Other than that, I think this is it for this area. Don't see anything else in here. If I haven't missed anything. So, let me go back to base now. Okay, I regeared, put on some iron pants, crafted a new pickaxe, and cleared out the inventory, put the wool in the ender chest. So, let's take a peek at the orange wool. And this is making me nervous already. Don't like going up staircases. If there's all those ledges above where monsters could drop down. And putting a stone pressure plate right here would also be a very good test trap. Okay, so please don't draw me. Nothing. Okay, from now on, this playthrough is completely blind and this looks very spooky already. Jesus. Is this going to be an underwater area? It looks like it. Totally useful for this... totally useful weapon for this area. You're welcome. Okay. Thank you. Of course. It's a nice grinder weapon, but other than that... S. Diving helmet. Well, I guess... we'll have to use this one. Okay, they're just infinite. Basically. Is this trapped in any way? I don't think so. Holy chaos. Sadly, we don't have depth strata yet. Is there any reason for me to attack those lupus boxes? There are air pockets beneath. Okay, there's squids stacked in with minecarts stacked on top. Oh, jeez, that scared me. Aqua affinity. Yeah, that's where those guys are coming from. I'm not sure if I would want to destroy the spawner. Ah, screw it, they're not going. But I can't build a grinder right here. So, let's just leave it for now. Okay, definitely like the looks of this area already, even though I can only move super slowly. And I'm still running out of air. Why did I not get any water breathing potions? Our spawner that spawns water breathing potions. Okay, yeah, those mobs are really not getting anywhere dangerously close to me. Are we going to find blazes right here? I mean, they would work, even though they can't light you on fire, which is basically their main damage. Creepers! Okay, I certainly don't want creepers. Great! And let's put a torch in the middle. Yay! It was easy. Oh, the skellies can drown. They don't have water breathing as well, that's good, I guess. Okay, those creepers are really no big deal. That minecart scared me. Slide this up. This area is really, really cool. I haven't seen anything like that in the CTM map yet. Completely underwater. Just say, respect for that. Even though the aesthetics aren't super detailed and great, like in most CTM maps, I really like this map so far. Don't have too many complaints. Okay, let's see. Oh, that was so dumb. All those chests are making me nervous. Okay, how can I fix this like that? Perfect. Woo! Holy jeez! Nice. 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 Extremely nice. Because I want lighting for underwater. Wow, already maxed out boots. Books, are you kidding me? It's really, really nice. Okay, I'll definitely loot this later. Let me take some of the potions. I could actually use them. Some health and speed. Let's leave the rest here. Probably not even use nearly as many as I grabbed there, but oh well. Let's go right here. We can't keep going for too long, because then the episode will get too long and that would be bad. Yeah. Go ahead, creeper. Okay, let's spam this with torches like we're doing with everything in this map. Thank god that creeper died in 2 hits. Do those mobs drop anything special? Wow! What? My helmet didn't take damage yet. Jesus! Okay, that's crazy. Yeah, you can stay there. I don't know for how much longer I should keep going. Let's do one more room. Let's hope it's not the boss room. Even though I should make for a really productive episode. It caused me a lot of terror, probably. Of course, there's just a super long hallway and I forgot that I can sprint underwater. It's at least something I have to move somewhat quickly. Okay, anything in this tunnel? Holy Jesus. This area is really, really cool, I have to say. Very, how do you say that? Very inventive. It's coming up with lots of new things I've never seen before. Well, lots of. The general theme of the area is something I've never really seen before, like a giant underwater complex. Yeah. Okay, I think that was it. Let's go back there, why not? I think that's the path to the next intersection. I don't know. From now on it's completely blind, I can't tell. Oh yeah, perfect. Question is, should I move my base to here? This is what I do. By the way, should I move my base to right here, or should I... Holy chaos. Zombie disco, holy Jesus. Wondering why this isn't causing... You and your parkour, Smigelo. It's gonna get me... Oh, of course. Was too quick there. Let's try this again. And there's a chest in the middle of the intersection. Okay, if I want to the teleporter, I need to make this parkour. Let's be careful. Whoa, this is a 3-block, 1 high. Luckily... Oh, there's another 3-block, 1 high. Are you kidding me? I would cover this lava before teleporting. Sounds like a rather smart idea. Have to say. I knew there would be more. It's probably gonna spawn me right down there. So mean. Does it go even deeper than this? No, it doesn't. Okay, let's completely dig this out so I don't have to worry about anything. Perfect! Do I have to do the parkour every time or am I allowed to place blocks? I would really like to know that. Because at the start, in the start area, there was a sign, please refrain from using blocks on the parkour, and there was a parkour there, so what did he only mean that single, particularly one parkour with that, or did he mean parkour in general in this map? Okay, dig. What? Oh, I see. And there's isn't a chest under the middle of the intersection. Okay, let's check out the intersection a bit. Because it didn't spawn me down there. I Okay, let's jump back. I guess if I fall here, this wouldn't be too big of a deal. But oh well. And the parkour isn't big a big of a deal anyway. The freaking water temple. And supplies for our homemade base. Wow, holy cows. Yeah, I'm really wondering, should I move my base to here or should I wait for the victory monument? Is the victory monument anywhere? This area. Let's just do this. Yellow wool, light blue wool. Doesn't look like it. Okay, this will be the hard area of this intersection. Yeah, this will be easy, this will be medium, and this will be hard. Okay, cool. So, I think this is going to do. Oh no, zombie disco. Should we check it out? This isn't an area of the intersection, actually. Whew. Almost fell there. That's one sick beat. Zombies now. How to party. The zombies are harmless, by the way. What are you waiting for? Why am I not trusting this? Can I test this? Oh yeah, they're actually harmless. Oh my god, this is so fun. Minus 10 attack damage. LOL! Oh my god, this is so awesome. I'm guessing this is his way of giving me blaze rods or what? Oh my god, this is so funny. Oh well, yeah. We don't want to. As I've said some times again, I don't want this episode with overlength. So yeah, thanks a lot for watching, everybody. I really hope you enjoyed this episode. I'm gonna do. I don't know if I will move my base on camera or not, we'll have to see. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed, and hopefully, see you all next time again. Bye!